Dear students, in this session we will discuss two variable transformation, are also known as bivariate transformation. So let x and y be random variable with mean mu x and mu y. That means we have bivariate random variable x and y, are two dimensional random variable with the mean mu x and mu y respectively. That means mu x is the mean of the random variable x and mu y is the mean of the random variable y. Let these random variables be transformed to other random variables u and v such that, that means this is the transformation, u is equal to ax plus by and v transform to cx plus dy. So u transform to ax plus by and v cx plus dy. So then we can find the mean value of u, variance of mean value of u as well as mean value of v, variance of u as well as variance of v, and covariance of u and v. So let us see how to find the mean of u. Mean of u means expected value of u. Expected value of u is the expected value of the right hand side, and expected value is a linear. Therefore, you can write it as expected value of u is equal to a into expected value of x plus b into expected value of y. Therefore, mean value of u, expected value of u, or you can write it as mu suffix u, which is equal to a into expected value of x. Expected value of x is mean of x, that is mu suffix x. Similarly, the second term is b into expected value of y, that is b into mean value of y, that is mu y. Similarly, if v is equal to cx plus dy, mean value of v is equal to a into mean value of x plus d into mean value of y. So this is the mean of the transformations u and v respectively. So next we find the variance of u and v, and the formula, the definition of variance is, it is denoted by sigma u square, which is the expected value of u minus mean value of u whole square. U minus its mean value whole square is nothing but variance of the random variable u. It is denoted by sigma u square. So in place of u, because u is transformed to ax plus b, in place of u we substitute ax plus by. Ax plus by. Similarly, mu u, that means mean value of u is, mean value of u is what? A into mean value of x plus b into mean value of y. But minus into plus becomes minus, because minus of a mu x plus b mu y. So if you multiply by minus, you will get minus a mu x minus b mu y whole square. Therefore, the next step is, so ax minus a mu y, if I combine these two, I can take a common. If you take a common, then here I am remaining with x, and here it is mu x. So a into x minus mu x. Similarly, if I combine these two terms with the variable y, then you can write it as b common here, b into y minus mu y. But we have whole square, so whole power 2. So we have a into x minus mu x plus b into y minus mu y whole square. So once, if you use the formula a plus b whole square formula, you can write it as square of the first term. What is square of the first term? A square x minus mu x whole square plus 2 times a b, 2 times first term into second term. So that means 2 into first term, a into x minus mu x first term, second term, b into y minus mu y. If you multiply these two, you will get 2 times a b x minus mu x y minus mu y plus square of the second term. If you square the second term, what is square of b? B square into y minus mu y whole square. B square y minus mu y whole square. So we will get this much. Since E is a linear operator, is a linear operator, you can write, you can use the linearity property of the expectation, then you can write this the next step. What is that next step? A square constant outside, expected value of this function plus 2ab, write it outside, then expected value of these two functions plus b square, write it outside, then expected value of y minus mu y whole square, right? So therefore variance of u will be equal to a square, and we know that this is the variance of x. By the definition of variance of x, expected value of x minus its mean whole square is variance of x. Therefore sigma x square plus 2ab, and recall the definition of this, this is actually expected value of x minus mu x into y minus mu y, which is the covariance of xy. This is the definition of covariance of xy. Is what? Covariance of xy is expected value of x minus mu x into y minus its mean, right? So therefore this is covariance of xy plus b square into, you can see that this is the definition of variance of y. Variance of y is expected value of y minus mu y whole square. So this is sigma y square. Similarly, if v is equal to cx plus dy, then the variance of v is c square variance of x plus 2 into cd covariance of x and y plus d square into variance of y. Next, we will find covariance of uv. And by definition of covariance, covariance of uv is expected value of u minus its mean into v minus its mean. So v minus mu v, this is the definition of covariance of two random variables. So this is equal to, in place of u, u is transformed to ax plus by. Therefore in place of u, write ax plus by. Then a mean of u is a into mean x plus b into mean y. Since we are multiplying by minus, you will get minus a mu x minus b mu y. Similarly, in place of v, write cx plus dy, because v transform to cx plus dy, minus in place of mu v, write c into mean value of x minus d into mean value of y, because you are multiplying by minus. So the next step is, I will combine ax minus a mu x. So take a common, x minus mu x, right inside the bracket. Similarly, take from these two terms b common, y minus mu y, right? So close this bracket with the flower bracket here. Then come to this one. So cx minus c mu x, combine these two. C is a constant, common, x minus mu x. Similarly, combine these two, plus d into y minus mu y, y minus mu y. So close the bracket. So then we need to find the expected value of this product. Clear? So therefore this is equal to expected value of, now do the multiplication. You know the multiplication of a plus b into c plus d, a plus b into c plus d. So use that multiplication. If you use that multiplication, first I will multiply this with the first term here. So a into x minus mu x into c into x minus mu x. So that can be written as a c into x minus mu x whole square. X minus mu x, x minus mu x whole square. Similarly, if I multiply this with the last term, I have factors x minus mu x, y minus mu y. Similarly, if I multiply these two, I have the factor x minus mu x, y minus mu y. So that means b into c, then a into d. The common factor is x minus mu x, y minus mu y. So if you take this common factor outside, you will get a into d plus b into c, or b into c plus a into d times x minus mu x, y minus mu y. See this, x minus mu x into y minus mu y. Plus, if I multiply the last terms, b into d plus b into d into y minus mu y, y minus mu y. So b into d, y minus mu y whole square. So I will get all these terms. So this is equal to, once again, if you use the linearity property of the expectation, then you can write this one in the form AC expected value of x minus mu x whole square plus this constant BC plus AD into expected value of this factors x minus mu x y minus mu y plus B into D constant expected value of this function y minus mu y whole square. So this is equal to AC, and as we know, this is sigma x square, variance of x. Expected value of x minus mu x whole square is variance of x. That means sigma x square. Similarly, this is constant. Write it as it is. And expected value of x minus mu x into y minus mu y is covariance of xy. Covariance of xy plus the last term is bd into expected value of y minus mu y whole square is sigma y square, variance of the random variable y. So this is the covariance of u and v, where u is equal to ax plus by and v is equal to cx plus dy. So therefore note that if u is equal to ax plus by and v is equal to cx plus dy, then mean of u is equal to a into mean of x plus b into mean of y. Similarly, mean of v is equal to c into mean value of x plus d into mean value of y. And the variance sigma u square is equal to, you can remember with a trick here. What is the trick? Sigma u square, if you want, use the formula a plus b whole square. That means square of the first term. If you square the first term, you will get a square into x square, right? In place of x square, you write sigma x square plus 2 into ab, 2ab into xy. So in place of xy, you write covariance of xy, covariance of xy plus square of the last term, by whole square. That means b square into y square. In place of y square, you write sigma y square. So this way you can remember the variance of u if u is equal to ax plus b. Similarly, sigma v square is equal to c square sigma x square plus 2cd covariance of xy plus d square sigma y square. And then covariance of uv, covariance of uv, you can remember like this. So multiply this, ax into cx, a into c, x square, right? So you write ac in place of x square, write sigma x square plus, see this, ax dy plus by cx. That means a into d, multiply the coefficient of x, a into d, then b into c plus b into c. So a into d xy, similarly b into c xy, yx or xy. That means in place of xy, you write covariance of xy plus multiply these two, b into d y into y square. In place of y square, write sigma y square. You can use this trick to remember the variance of u, variance of v and covariance of uv. This will be helpful to you while solving the problems. Consider the problem. If x is a random variable with mean 4 and the standard deviation is given, that is 5, and y is a random variable with mean 6 and standard deviation 7, the correlation coefficient is also given, that is rho xy. The correlation coefficient is minus 0.7. And if u, transformation u is equal to 3x plus 2y, so x and y transform to u, so u is equal to 3x plus 2y. What are the variance of u and covariance of ux and covariance of uy? So solution is, so just I will note down the given things here. One is mu x is given. So then mu y is given 6, then sigma x, standard deviation of the random variable x, comma standard deviation of the random variable y, 7, and the correlation coefficient is also given, which is equal to minus 0.7, and the transformation. The transformation is u is equal to 3x plus 2y. So this is also given. So we need to find the variance of u. To find the variance of u, as I told earlier, sigma u square, you can remember like this, square of this plus 2 times this into this plus square of this. So wherever x square, write sigma x square, wherever y square, sigma y square, and wherever xy, write covariance of xy. So that means we need to find covariance of xy, that is required. So therefore first I will find covariance of xy. So the covariance of xy is equal to that is a correlation coefficient, because correlation coefficient between x and y is equal to covariance of xy divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y, or covariance of xy is a correlation coefficient into sigma x into sigma y. So all the values are given here. So substitute those values, sigma x 5, sigma y 7, and the correlation coefficient minus 0.7. If you substitute all these values, you will get 5 into 7 into minus 0.7, which is equal to minus 24.5. then we can find variance of u. So variance of u, that is sigma u square, this is equal to, so square this, if you square, what you will get? 3 square into x square, 3 square is 9, in place of x square I will write sigma x square plus 2 into 3 into 2, 2 into 3, 2 3s are 6, 6 2s are 12 into x into y, in place of xy you write covariance of xy plus square of this, 2 square is 4, and y square is sigma y square. So substitute, all the values are available here. So covariance is minus 24.5, substitute here. Similarly, substitute sigma x square 5 square and sigma y square, that is 7 square. So if you substitute all these things here, you will get 9 into sigma x square is 25 plus 12 into covariance of xy is minus 24.5 plus 4 into sigma y square is 7 square, 49. This is equal to 127. So if you simplify this, you will get 127. Next, to find the covariance of ux, consider u is equal to, what is u? U is equal to 3x plus 2y. So in place of v I have x, therefore I will take v is equal to x. So x means, so 1 into x plus 0 into y. If you want, you can take write it as 0 into y. So 1 into x plus 0 into y. So now we can find covariance of u v. So that is covariance of u v. So v means, remember that v is equal to x, right? So covariance of u v is equal to, so remember that formula, covariance of u v is equal to, so 3 into 1, 3, x into x, x square, in place of x, right, x square, right, sigma, in place of x square, right, sigma x whole square, that is sigma x square, plus 3x into 0y, so that is 0, then 2y into x, 2xy, so therefore it is 2 into xy, in place of xy write covariance of xy, and then plus so 2y into 0, 0, so 2 into 0, 0, therefore it is 0, or this is equal to 3 into sigma x square. What is sigma x square? sigma x is 5, sigma x square is 25. So sigma x is 5, therefore sigma x square is 25 plus 2 into covariance of xy. We found that the covariance of xy is minus 24.5. So if you simplify this, you will get 26. Similarly, covariance of uy is equal to 24.5. If you follow the similar steps, so you take v is equal to 0x plus 1 into y, and if you follow the same formula, if you use the same formula, you will get 24.5. Here, covariance of uv means covariance of u into v is x. Ux. So the covariance of ux is 26, covariance of uy is 24.5.